Okay, in this session, we talk about parallel lines. Parallel lines. Now, when you talk about parallel lines, you talk about two lines that continue without meeting, and the symbol we use to show that two lines are parallel are the arrows. So, okay, sometimes you could see just one and one, and sometimes you could see two arrows like this. Sometimes they could be three, they could be four. Forget about that. So as long as they are either one and one or two, two, three, three. If this is one and this is two, it shows that, of course, they are not parallel. It has to be the same number of arrows on it. Okay, on the line. Okay, now if you draw, so these are parallel, if you draw a line on it or across it, that's the transversal line, that is transverse, it cuts two parallel lines. This line automatically creates with these two parallel, with this pair of parallel lines, that's the two parallel lines, it creates, automatically creates eight angles. So you have angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, angle E, angle F, angle G, and angle H. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A. Now it creates, automatically creates eight angles. Okay, so let's look at some of the parallel lines and see the things that we should know about it. Number one, if you have a set of parallel line and a transversal line crossing across, okay, now the angle here underneath this, which we could call angle A, or let's follow the pattern here, angle D, and the line, the angle here, which is angle H. Angle D and H are equal. Now, the term we use is corresponding, or F angle. Now, it looks like an F, like an F. So, either corresponding or F angles. Corresponding or F angles. Now, it doesn't stop with that. D and H, this under this parallel line on this side, under this parallel line on this side, they are equal. Now, on top of this parallel line, which is A, okay, let me write that first. D equals to H. Now, on top of this parallel line, which is A, and on top of this parallel line, which is E, A is also equals to E. They are corresponding, or F angle, F. The F is upside down, facing that side. So, F angle, A and E are also the same. That's not all. Also, the angle here, which is C, and the angle underneath here too, which is under the same parallel lines, this parallel line, this parallel line, which is G, C equals to G. They are corresponding angles, or F angle, F, the F facing this side. Then, the angle on top of this, which is D, is also equals to the angle on top of this, which is F, both on facing your left-hand side. So B equals to F. So that's that. The next is, let's look at this, the another set of parallel lines, this, and let's see this cutting across. Let me put in my parallel symbol here, on this parallel line. So the next, relationship between parallel lines and that one we'll quickly look at is the alternate angles. Now, when you talk about alternate angles, you're talking about angles that are in a Z-like shape. Okay, for example, we already know this as a D. So if this is the D, now if you form like a Z, like this, and like this, this is F. So D and F are alternate. So D is equal to F. D is equal to F. When we say equal, it means if D is 60, F will also be 60. If D is 150, D F will also be 150. Now, those are not the only two angles that are alternate. Another alternate set of alternate angles are this, which is a C, and this, which is a E. The Z goes like this. Can you see that? So, Z angles. So, C is equal to E. So if C is 50, E also has to be 50. So remember, I said this is corresponding. So you don't forget. Now this is alternate. They they are always equal. Now, another relationship we should also know is, let's still put our parallel lines with the transversal line now cutting across. Another set of relationship we should know is what we call the interior angles or the C angle. It looks like a C. Look at this. It becomes like this. Like a C. This angle and this angle, they add up to 180. Interior angles add up to 180. So, of course, if this is a D and this is a E, D plus E will give you 180 degrees. Now, in parallel lines, that's not the only interior angle we have. The other set of interior angle we have is this interior. It's a C facing the other side. Now, in this case, let's say this is a C and this is a F. C plus F is also equal to what? 180 degrees. You understand? So that's the set of interior angles that that you can find in a parallel line that just two parallel lines. Okay, now this point of our parallel lines could continue. You could have another line coming this way. You know, this T another C, this T another C. This is this. You could have another line coming like this. This would be this and this will be equal, then this and this will be equal. You understand? So it's the parallel lines can continue, but we're just limiting it to just two lines. Okay, now let's just really give ourselves an example. We have this and this. Okay, now we know that let's give this as 120. And this is A, this is B, this is C, this is D, E, F, and G. Okay, now, if we look at these parallel lines, I hope you know that I didn't talk about vertical opposite, but in my last session, I talked about vertical opposite angles. Opposite angles come when you have cross this thing, because I've already seen that, but I didn't just want to talk about that. But you should also know, if you have watched a video of mine on angle facts, you will see that I also talk about vertically opposite angles. This and this are equal, this and this are equal, this and this are equal, this and this are equal. So let's leave that. Okay, now let's try to get all the angles here without wasting much time. Now, if this is 120, corresponding is E here, E is equal to 120, so this is 120. Now, if this is 120 corresponding, now for vertically opposite angles, or let's leave vertical, since I didn't talk about vertically opposite, let me focus on this. Now, for alternate angles, this is 120. If you have your Z angle, look at your Z angle, if this is 120, B will be what? 120. You get that? So, also for corresponding, B is equal to G. B is under this and G is under this. This G is also 120. Okay, so we seem to have gotten all the large angles. Let's see if we can get the smaller angles. Now, sum of angle at a point is 180 degrees. This and this. 120 plus A add up to 180 degrees. That's sum of angle at a point. That means this will be equal to 60. 60 plus 120 gives you 180. Then, if this is 60, this is corresponding to this. A and D are the same, so D also should be 60, right? Now, if this is 60, using alternate angle, that is Z angle, C is also equal to what? 60. Now, if C is 60, F is corresponding to this, so F is also 60. You can see just using corresponding alternate and corresponding alternates, we didn't even apply the interior angles. We applied sum of angles at a point. Okay, we could get all the angles needed in that question. Thanks. We'll move on to the next class now.